wananchi wa kaskazini, hamjambo? Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi taala wabarakatu. Asanteni sana. Kaskazini hoye! Kaskazini hoye! Leo nina furaha ambayo haina kifani, manake tangu tufike hapa Garissa jana tulipata mapokezi ya kipekee, na baadaye tukawa na mkutano na vijana wa eneo hii yote jioni, kisha baadaye tukakutana na wale mashehe na maimams leo hii, na baadaye tukaja kwa kongamano hii ya leo. Maneno mengi yamesema hapa tangu tufike hapa. Waswahili wanasema ati maneno matamu kumtoa nyoka pangoni. Nyoka imetoka. Furaha kubwa sana. Kuna maneno mengi ambayo watu wamenena hapa, sitaki kuyarudia. Niko na maneno machache ambayo mimi niliweka chini, na mimi nitasema yale ambayo niliweka chini, baadaye nitarudia kwa lugha ya Kiswahili. Nimekuruhusia mimi nifanye namna hiyo. Northern Kenya, comprising the counties of Garissa, Wajir, Mandera, Isiolo, na Marsabit, is the face of marginalization and inequitable sharing of the wealth of the nation, which we call shared prosperity. Droughts, floods, insecurity, poverty, hunger, lack of water, poor access to education and healthcare services, poor infrastructure, all reside here. But all these problems can and must be fixed. As the Prime Minister, I created the Ministry of Development of Northern Kenya and Arid Lands, and I appointed Honorable Elmi as the Minister in charge. Although he later abandoned me, the Minister died. But I still believe we need a Ministry of Northern Kenya and other arid lands. Given a chance, I will recreate that ministry and give it more power to unlock the huge economic potential of this region. Education and training. Insecurity made teachers run away from this region. I will therefore push for a special affirmative action program in admitting students from ASAL into teacher training institutions and universities, to create a local committed workforce to serve as teachers and education officers in the region. We'll build and equip modern low-cost boarding schools in each sub-county in ASAL areas. Upscale the school feeding program to maximize student retention and completion of school. Initiate water for schools program to have all schools in the region connected to water system. Strengthen both the formal school system and the mobile school initiatives among the pastoralist communities as a means of increasing access to education. Affirmative action programs that force the government to take over the provision of the modern infrastructure and items like tents in the case of mobile schools, solar power, books, desks, toilets, and sanitation from the soldiers or the pastoralists, parents and their children. Resilient livestock economy. we formulate a veterinary policy that benefits the livestock sector. We'll ensure availability of quality feeds and supplements, improving livestock breeds and breeding and improving animal health, promoting adoption of improved livestock technologies, improve the market access and trade by promoting agribusiness along the livestock and livestock products, enhancing the safety of foods of animal origin, and strengthening the livestock marketing infrastructure and information systems. We'll ensure emergency programs for the drought that hits Northern Kenya community time and again. The response readiness must include rapid delivery of food, medicines, water and medicine to affected populations. We'll ensure livestock offtake by the Kenya Meat Commission and the borehole drilling. Water investment and investment in water infrastructure for livestock and domestic usage. The Badasa Dam fell victim to corruption and greed. Its completion is a priority. Fast track the completion of the Seven Falls Dams project. There have been discussions on the High Grand Falls Dam for the last more than 10 years. The project was tendered and a BOT granted worth $2 billion in 2016. Till today, nothing moves. The people of Garissa and Tana River suffer every year from flooding, and the current five dams of the Seven Falls cannot control the water when there is excessive rain. Also, sometimes water has to be released from some dams when there is too much rainfall, and this also causes flooding. The Higher Grand Falls would not only control the flooding, but also provide Garissa with water for irrigation. Enhance availability of fodder and pasture. Help the community access abattoirs and a market for their livestock and livestock products. The youth. Youth must access education as the surest bet to prepare them for the world. Youth from Asal areas are people on the move. I will pursue the youth jobs immigration program to review the quality of jobs offered to the Kenyan youth abroad and ensure the security of young Kenyans taking up such jobs and make the entire process friendly, transparent, and accountable. I will create a toll-free youth call center. I have a digital platform that allows any young person to get any information on the youth opportunities across government departments on their phone. Design a policy for youth leaders program, both global and local, by supporting the 1,000 youth every year with paid up internship in the UN and other international agencies across the world to ensure them grow and be infused with best practices by developed countries. With the help of the national government, the private sector, we could also roll out a 10,000 per year Kenya National Youth Internship Program. For the enterprising youth here, which majority are, I will create a tax holiday for youth enterprises, minimize taxation of new and small youth-owned businesses by giving them a tax holiday of 7 years, in addition to extending tax incentives to organizations and companies that offer enterprises and employment to the youth. I will ensure real action not just policies on paper, to enable young people to start and stay in business. Ease of doing business in Kenya must begin with particular attention to and providing accountability mechanisms for how easy it is for young people to start a venture build up a business. The tax holiday for youth businesses must be a reality, but it's just a start. We will revamp and empower and activate the youth one-stop shops, provide strategic youth focused services, including access to ICT, entrepreneurship training, and guidance and counseling on drugs and substance abuse, HIV/AIDS prevention, among others. There is the issue of ICT and the issue of IDs. Access to Kenyan security and identification documents, particularly ID cards and passports. We first track removal of youth from refugee database where poverty drove them and have them listed as key citizens. This is a very important and sensitive subject. As a Prime Minister, I directed my minister in charge of immigration to open a passport office here in Garissa. I am told that that office was closed. We will reopen it. And we will ensure that Kenyans who have attained the age of 18 are automatically issued with the identity cards. We know that there are a number of youth who are forced by the circumstances to register as refugees to be able to access food which was being given to the refugees in the camps. These are Kenyans. And I know that the government set up a task force to look into this matter. We would like that the recommendation of that task force to be implemented. And these youth, upon verification, should be automatically registered and issued the ID cards as Kenyans. Women. We will provide women with the opportunity to earn a living. Work with the government, NGOs, and UN agencies to help women engage in businesses and agriculture. Support women to go for leadership and public service positions. And we'll give women ID cards and passports. We'll help girls access education. Gong sasa. Mimi nataka kusema namna hii. Naambia watu wa kaskazini wa Kenya. At kaskazini ni Kenya. Na Kenya hii hakuna kabila ambayo iko hapa kwa mwaliko ya mwingine. Kila Mkenya ni Mkenya by right. We have historical issues to deal with. But those issues can be addressed so that Kenya becomes united. We know also that we have a border with Somalia. But we also have got a border with Ethiopia, with South Sudan, with Uganda, with Tanzania. We know the security issues. As a Prime Minister, I was party to the decision to take KDF into Somalia. And we know the challenges that are in Somalia. But that is not a reason for restricting the trade between our people and Somalia. It is possible to be able to open up the border with certain provisions, and these are issues that will be discussed with the KDF so that the economy along our border does not suffer. We can allow our people to do businesses with the people of Somalia. So this region is a rich region. There's water flowing from up country through Tana River is passing through Garissa here, carrying a lot of water into the Indian Ocean. Indian Ocean does not need water. We need this water here inland. And there's already a plan to build a Grand Falls Dam. Tujenge hiyo bwawa ya Grand Falls, tuvune maji ya mto Tana ili tuweze kulisha watu wa eneo hii na kunyunyiza mashamba ili chakula itoke pande hii ya kutosha. Inawezekana. 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 Tunataka kuona kama eneo hii ambayo kuna mifugo mingi zaidi, uchumi ya wafugaji inaimarishwa, tujenge viwanda vya kichinjio hapa Garissa, ingine kule Wajia, hata Mandera hapo Wajia tuko na kiwanja kubwa ya ndege. Ndege inaweza kuchukua nyama kutoa hapa kipeleke kule Dubai, kule Saudia kadhalika. Kwa hivyo hawa watu wafugaji sio watu ambao inatakikana wawe mafukara, na tunajenga vilevile viwanda hapa, viwanda ya kutumia ngozi ambayo inatoka kwa mifugo kutengeneza leather. Tunaweza kutengeneza viatu hapa, vile Ethiopia inafanya. Ukienda kule Moyale unakuta kama watu wetu wananunua leather products ambazo zinatoka Ethiopia na zinaingia katika soko yetu. Kenya inaweza kuwa self sufficient in leather products tukitumia mbinu yetu. Kwa hivyo sisi tunasema eneo hii inaweza kuinuka, na tayari tulipokuwa katika Grand Coalition Government tulifanya mpango ya kutosha. Ile wizara ya Bwana Elmi ilifanya utafiti mingi zaidi, yale yote yanalala tu kule katika nini, magala ya serikali. Tutayatoa na tutayatekeleza mapendekezo ambayo ziko ndani ya hizo reports ili eneo hii iinuke. Na vijana wa pande hii, vijana niliongea nao jana, naambia hii ni wakati yao. Mapinduzi ya tatu ni ya mapinduzi ya uchumi na kuinua vijana, ili vijana waweze kuwa kama wale ambayo watakuwa wanazalisha mali kwa taifa letu. The youth of our country need to be empowered so that they can be able to create wealth in our country. You in 2013 there was a promise of one laptop for each child in primary school. Those children who are supposed to be digital are going to finish now their high school. They need proper digital jobs. You do not promise them digital jobs now, you atumambia hawa ati kazi ni kazi. And sasa tunataka kuwapatia hawa wa wilbaro. Hiyo sio ngwana. Sisi tunataka vijana wetu wapate kazi wa maana ili waweze kusaidia kwa uzalishaji wa rasilimali katika taifa letu. Na mimi na hakika ya kwamba tukiungana kama Wakenya tunaweza kufanya. Ndiyo sababu ya azimio ya umoja, ili tuungane pamoja kama Wakenya, na inawezekana. Na nikisema semeni inawezekana. Umoja, umoja, amani, amani, uchumi bora, uchumi bora, kilimo, mifugo, utaifa. Asanteni sana.